does is it allows you to know how deep you feel the pressure. So the speed at which you do it is equivalent to Nelly the Elephant. So you do 30 days fast, it's 100 per minute. So, and you do it at a depth of 5 to 6 centimetres. So quite hard pushing, it's quite a workout. You do 2-minute cycles and then you reassess the rhythm. And you do a rate of 30 compressions of your breath. But now they're saying it's more important you do the compressions. So if you didn't want to breathe into a stranger's back, you can just keep going with chest compressions. You landmark by going under the armpit and bringing your hand to the centre of the chest. So you don't have to measure anything, you just go from the armpit across. Okay? And then it's belly the elephant. That's speed. Okay? And that's depth. What you can do is you can feel it click when you get down there with your time. Do you want to have a go? Well, okay, does that give you an idea about what you do? So, essentially, if you found someone, if someone was collapsed now, you make sure it was safe for you to approach. Okay, so that's the first thing. Take Dr. Amy's lead. So, is there any danger to yourself? For example, if they've been electrocuted. If the area is safe, you then approach. And then the next one on Dr. ABC is ask, response. So you ask, hello, can you hear me? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? And if there's no response, you then assess to see if there's any signs of life. So you feel the pulse and you look to listen and feel for their breathing. So you can assess here. So the other thing you can do is just look and see if their chest is moving up and down, or if you can feel their breath on their cheeks. And if they're not breathing, and there's no compulsion, then you start compression to get help. A compression will only keep you going until your help comes. So the sooner you get help, the better. You can phone 999 outside Car Country in Norwich City Centre. And then you start your 30-second compressions. Okay? Yeah. But worst case scenario is damage. You can't wake someone up and they're not breathing. If you started doing that and they weren't breathing, they'd soon tell me, hold on. So you've got to remember that, okay? But if they're definitely not breathing and you can't get them to respond, you call for help, get someone to come as soon as they can, and then you start your 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 15, 16, 17, 18. I'm a doctor. So paramedics attend on the scene to any kind of emergency, and then they usually assess whether they need to come to A&E or not. They can do a lot of things, including resuscitation, taking blood cannulas and managing acute first aid type things. And a doctor, we train for 5 years and then we continue our training for up to